A very good morning to all of you, my dear children. Today we are going to start a new chapter named Plant Kingdom. Plant Kingdom includes all the plants which are green in color and can carry out photosynthesis. Because they possess chloroplast, which in turn contains chlorophyll. Cells are surrounded by cell wall, mainly composed of cellulose. Along with cellulose, other substances like pectin may be present. Sex organs are multicellular and jacketed. Various scientists proposed various types of classification on the basis of various types of characteristic features. Earlier, fungi and the members of Monera and the Protista having cell walls were put under the kingdom Plantae. But now they have been excluded from the kingdom. So the cyanobacteria that are also referred as blue-green algae are not algae anymore. Whittaker proposed five kingdom classification in the year 1969, which is widely accepted by most of the scientists all over the world. According to Whittaker's classification, plant kingdom contains five groups: algae, bryophyta, pteridophyta, gymnosperm, and angiosperms. First, they are grouped on the basis of their habitat, whether plants grow in water or land. If the plants grow in water, they are aquatic. Algae are included in this group. On the basis of characteristic feature, algae again are divided into three groups: chlorophyceae, rhodophyceae, and the phaeophyceae. Plants which grow on land, they are the terrestrial plants. Then we have to consider whether vascular tissue like xylem and phloem tissues are present or not. If xylem and phloem tissues are present, then they are included under bryophyta. On the basis of the characteristic features, bryophyta once again divided into two groups, liverworts and mosses. If vascular tissue like xylem, phloem are present, then we have to consider the mode of reproduction. If they are totally grow on land and water is not needed and reproduce by spore formation, then the organisms are grouped under pteridophyta. Example, fern. If plants produce seed, then they are grouped under spermatophyta. Then we have to consider whether seeds are covered or not. If the seeds are not covered, that means naked, then they are grouped under gymnospermy. If the seeds are covered, then they are grouped under angiosperms. Then we have to consider the number of cotyledons present in the seed. If the seed contains one cotyledon, then that group of angiosperms will be under monocotyledony. If the seeds contain two cotyledons, then that group of angiosperms will be included under dicotyledony. This five kingdom classification was proposed by Whittaker in the year 1969.